Hey y'all, welcome back to another Kayla's Curls video. Happy holidays and Merry Christmas to everybody and Happy New Year's as well. I hope everyone enjoys their holidays. So in this video, I wanted to share with you guys how I got these heatless curls on old straightened hair that I had done a couple days ago, almost a week ago. So I want to share with you guys how I got these cute heatless curls. So if you're interested, keep on watching. So for the hair products, I will be using my Dippity Doo Girls with Curls Curling Mousse, the Curl Boosting Mousse, and then I'm going to go ahead with the Cream of Nature, the Argan Oil Heat Protectant Serum. Now you do not have to use that, I use whatever oil I want. I also have here my Eco Styler Gel that I'll be using for my edges. And you will also need some combs and of course a toothbrush for those edges. And I also have this rat tail comb and a wide tooth comb for fluffing and parting. I also have here my brush, my paddle brush, and some hair ties for when I'm doing my bantu knotouts and sectioning. So this is what my hair is looking like after a week of it being straightened. I had straightened it a couple times afterwards, but this is what it's looking like. It's starting to get raggedy and old and getting reverted in some spots. So I started off by detangling from my ends to my roots. Even though it's straight, you still want to practice safe detangling. So I'm detangling from my ends to my roots just to get started on my hair. And for the style, I will be doing the bantu knot out method. This will help to make some nice curls on my hair, which will make it even better, because when your hair is straightened or blow-dried, the bantu knot outs come out amazing. So I'm going to go ahead and detangle my hair and then get right onto the next step that I'm going to do. So now that I have detangled my hair, I am just going to split my hair in half so I could do the bantu knot outs in sections. I will be doing 6 bantu knot outs, so I'm separating my hair in half to work on the sections easier, and then I'm going to tie down the one side that I'm not working on. So now that I am done separating my hair in half, I am now going to section off my first bantu knot out. The first bantu knot out is going to be a medium size. All the bantu knot outs are going to be medium size. So I'm going to take my Cream of Nature Argan Oil and I'm going to take a good amount and just moisturize my hair with it. This is going to add some great moisture and shine to your hair. So now that I've added my argan oil, I'm just going to detangle to make sure that the products are evenly distributed. And then I'm going to go in with my Dippity Doo Girls with Curls Curling Defining Mousse. And this will give you some shine and some hold to your bantu knot outs so they do not come unraveled. And so that your hair is nice and moisturized and shiny. So once I've added that, I'm just going to detangle and then get right into the bantu knot out. So all I'm doing is twisting my hair until it builds like a little knot. And then I hold the knot while I twist the rest of my hair around it. And this is what builds the bantu knot out. You want to wrap your hair as tightly as possible so that you can secure the ends underneath the bantu knot outs. If you don't, it will fall apart and it will not look cute at all. And if you do need like some bobby pins or a hair tie to tie it down, I recommend doing that. I did have to tie a couple of the bantu knot outs that I did. So as you can see, I am tucking my ends underneath the bantu knot outs so that it does not fall out. And there is my first Bantu knot. It is looking good and shiny and moisturized. So I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing to the rest of this side of my hair. And then I'm going to come back to show you guys how it is looking. So this is what the Bantu knotouts are looking like. There's 6 in total, and I did have to tie 2 of them because they were coming out. So I'm going to go take a nice rest while these dry and come back. So now it's the morning time. I am ready to take out these bad boys. Here is what my hair is looking like. It is dry and ready to be taken down. So, the first thing that I will be doing is rubbing some oil on my hand. I am using the new Argan Oil from Cream of Nature. This is a heat protectant, but I also like using this for shine. And this also did help me to take down my hair a lot easier. So, I'm taking out the hair ties first. That is what I do. I make sure that all the Bantu knotouts have no hair ties in it. And then I will go ahead and take them down. So now I'm just going to untwist. Just the way you wrap them in, you want to untangle them the other way around, as you could see, and it comes out into this long looking Bantu knot out, and it looks really nice, like a bouncy little curl when it comes out. So I'm going to take them all down, then I'm going to come back and show you guys how I separate and style. So to separate my hair, all I'm doing is holding the piece of the Bantu knot out, and I am just grabbing little pieces from that section and just wrapping it around my finger so that the curls will stay curly and not get frizzy. This is why it is very important for you to have an oil on hand that you can use to take down the Bantu knot outs and separate, because that will help to reduce frizz. So all I'm doing, again, I am just picking up the Bantu knot out, and I am just taking little pieces and wrapping that piece around my finger so it keeps its curl. As you could see, the back was a little bit more curly than really a Bantu knot out, and that is because my hair was not completely dry, but that is okay because it still looked cute to me. So all I'm doing is taking them all down and separating, and then I will move on to what I do next. So now I'm going to go ahead and fluff with my wide tooth comb. You want to start from your roots to your ends, and you want to make sure to get those harsh lines where you parted your hair so that it does not look weird or funny. So I'm going to go ahead and fluff, and I will be back. So this is what my hair is looking like. It is nice and bouncy, defined, and very voluminous. It is looking really nice and shiny from the products that I decided to use. And I just want to mention that using oil is going to be your best friend because it will give your hair some shine and it will also moisturize your hair for the look that you are going for. So I wasn't sure of how I wanted to style my hair, and then I decided that maybe I should do something different. So I decided that I was going to do a side part just because I thought that that would look cute. You know, it's the holiday times, we have a little cute little style. So I decided that I wanted a side part. So this is me just creating a side part. And then I'm going to take my wide tooth comb just to fix any harsh lines in my hair and fluff that out. So now taking my Equal Styler Gel, I'm taking a goop amount and just putting that on my edges so I can smooth my edges down so my hair looks really neat. So I'm just smoothing the gel on my edges, and then I'm going to use an old toothbrush to do my edges. Alright y'all, so this brings me to the end of this video. This is what my hair is looking like. It is nice, bouncy, shiny, and curly, just in time for the holidays, for Christmas, for New Year's, whatever you name it. You guys, I hope that you guys have a great Christmas and a happy holidays, and of course a happy New Year's. This is the best time of year to be with your family and friends. Please do not forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more content. Thank you so much for coming to Kayla's Curls. Peace out, y'all. I hope you all have a great and fantastic holidays. So I will see you in my next one. Goodbye, guys. Do not forget to follow me on Instagram at KAYLASCURLS, Kayla's Curls. You will never miss an upload or a hairstyle. Instagram always sees it first. Peace out.